In this problem, I'm going to find the value of x that will make the two sides of this equation equal. It's a proportion where I have one fraction equal another fraction. So I'm going to find the value that makes it a true proportion. In order to do that, I can work with what is called the cross products. Anytime I have two fractions that are equal, it is true that the cross products of those fractions are also equal. So if these two fractions are equal, the product I get by multiplying the numerator of one times the denominator of the other is going to be equal to the product I get by multiplying the numerator of the other with the denominator that's diagonally across the equal sign. So in this problem, I have 1 and 2 sevenths times x as one cross product. And the other side, I have 1 and a half times 3 fifths. In order to do this problem, I see I'm working with some mixed numbers. And when I'm multiplying or dividing mixed numbers with fractions, I want to make the mixed numbers into improper fractions. So the first thing I'll do is 1 and 1 half changes to 1 times 2 plus 1 is 3 halves times 3 fifths. There's nothing that cancels in that multiplication, so I'll multiply across and get 9 over 10. On the left-hand side, I have a mixed number times x. I will go ahead and make that into an improper fraction. 1 times 7 is 7 plus 2 is 9. So now I have 9 sevenths x. On this side, I'm just going to bring that down. 9 sevenths x equal 9 tenths. So I still haven't solved for x by itself. I need to get rid of this number in front, this 9 sevenths that being multiplied. So I can divide both sides of the equation by 9 sevenths. Since I'm dividing by a fraction, that is the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal of the fraction. So what I can do is multiply both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of this fraction. So I'll multiply this side by 7 over 9, and I'll do the same to the other side. When I do that, on this side, the factors in the top and the bottom all cancel out, and I end up with x. On this side, I look, and I do see some canceling. I have a common factor of 9 in the top and the bottom, and I end up with 7 tenths. So x equals 7 tenths is the solution that will make the original proportion true. It will make the two sides equal to each other, the two fractions equal.